We magnify you. You are holy. You are holy. You are the King of all kings. You are the Lord of all lords. And so today we take off our crowns. We put it at your feet, oh God. We take off every worry, all stress, oh God. We put it at the feet of Jesus this morning. And so God, right now we just want to worship you today, God. We want to lift you up today, Holy Spirit. God, we ask you, Lord Jesus, that our worship would just be a sweet fragrance today, God. Holy Spirit, we just ask that you would just breathe in our worship, God. We magnify you. You are holy, God. We lift you up, Lord Jesus. We magnify the King of Kings. We exalt you, King of Israel. We magnify you. You are King of all kings. We lift you up today, God. We declare today, Lord Jesus, that the heavens are open. We thank you, Lord Jesus, that you are beginning to pour out your spirit today, God. We thank you, Holy Spirit, because there is living water in this room, oh God. Nothing is stale. Nothing is old, oh God. There is something fresh for your people today, Lord Jesus. And so, Holy Spirit, we've come with an expectation in our hearts, oh God. We've come with expectation on our lips, God. And so we ask you that you would do something new this morning, God. Do something new in our hearts. Do something new in our minds, oh God. We need a refreshing this morning, God. Refresh your people. Strengthen your people, oh God. God, we need your presence in this place. Where your presence is, oh God, where your spirit is, there is freedom. There is liberty. And so we put a demand on freedom this morning, God. Every person that has walked into this room, Lord, every person that has come bound, every person that has come heavy, every person that has come dragging, we ask you, God, to break every chain, oh God. Every knee shall bow in your presence. Everything has to bow when the Holy Spirit enters a room, oh God. So stress has to bow. Infirmity has to bow. We break every spirit of distraction this morning, God, and we declare, Lord Jesus, we can worship freely this morning, God. We can worship freely this morning. I need you to lift up your voice with me. I need you to help me. We need the presence of the Lord in this place. We need his glory to be in this room. Holy Spirit, we need you, God. We need you, God. We are desperate for you, Jesus. Holy Spirit, reveal your Son to us today, God. Reveal Jesus to us. So, Holy Spirit, we need you to walk in this room, oh God. We need your angels in this room, oh God. When your spirit is here, you're looking for someone to heal. You're looking for someone to set free, oh God. And so we say to you this morning, you can do it in this place. You can do it in us, oh God. God, if you are in this room, everything has to change. When you are in this room, heaviness has to go. When you are in this room, freedom is here with us, oh God. And so this morning, we put a demand on your peace this morning, God. We put a demand, Lord God, on a refreshing that has become available to us, God. We thank you, Holy Spirit. We thank you, God, for what you are doing. We thank you, Lord God, because there is a setup this morning. There is healing in the room, God. There is healing in the room, Jesus. Holy Spirit, we ask you to heal our hearts, oh God. Heal our minds, oh God. Do something new, Lord Jesus. We've come to celebrate the King of all kings. We've come to celebrate hope that was born. We've come to celebrate the King of all kings this morning, God. And we thank you, Lord Jesus, because freedom is here. We thank you, God, because healing is here. We thank you, Holy Spirit, because you are doing something in your people, oh God. We thank you, Lord Jesus, because you are setting us up for deliverance this morning. And so we thank you, Jesus. Does somebody believe that with me? Amen.
There's nothing like your presence, Lord. There's nothing like your presence, Lord. There's nothing like your presence, Lord. How many came for the presence of Jesus? There's nothing like your presence, Lord. nothing like your presence, there's nothing like your presence, Lord. Oh, we want you, there's nothing like your presence, Lord. Yeah. There's nothing like your presence, Lord. 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 Ooh, there's nothing like your presence, Lord. There's nothing like your presence, Lord. Oh, come on. How many are excited to be in the house of the Lord this morning? Come on, how many are excited to be in the house of the Lord this morning? There should be a new song, a new praise coming from your mouth. I'm grateful to be in the presence of the Lord. I'm grateful to have access to the presence of the Lord. Come on, clap your hands. More fire, more power, more of His Spirit, more of His presence.
Is anybody here with me? We're ready for more. How many are ready for more of Him? No, how many are ready for more of Him? When we sing this next part, I want you guys to sing this out with us. Amen.
Just like you did it before, Lord, we are ready for more. Just like you did it before, Lord, we are ready for more. Say,
just like you did it before,
Lord, we are ready for.
Lord, we are ready.
Grateful for you, Jesus. Come on, if you love Him, what's your prayer to Him this morning? What are your words for Him today? What's the declaration on your heart today? Lord, speak to us. Speak to us like never before, Jesus. We thank you.
Jesus, it's you. Jesus, it's you. You know the chorus. And I believe you're the wonder-working God. You're the wonder-working God. All the miracles I've seen, you're too good to not believe. The wonder-working God. And you heal because you love. All the miracles we'll see, you're too good to not believe. Too good to not believe. Too good to not believe. Oh, oh. And I can resurrect a man with my own hands. But just the mention of your name can raise the dead. And all the glory to the only one who can. Jesus, it's you. And Jesus, it's you. And I believe you're the wonder-working God. You're the wonder-working God. All the miracles, too good to not believe. The wonder-working. And you heal because you love. All the miracles we'll see. But you're good to not believe. You're the wonder working. You're the wonder working. All the miracles I've seen. But you're good to not believe. You're the wonder working. And you heal because you. Yeah, all the miracles we'll see. Too good to not believe. You're too good to not believe. You're too good to not believe. After everything I've seen, too good to not believe. You're too good to not believe. Too good to not believe. After everything I've seen, too good to not believe. Oh, 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 oh. I've seen cancer disappear. I've seen metal plates dissolve. Don't you tell me he can't do it. Don't you tell me he can't do it. And I've seen real life resurrection. And I've seen mental health restored. But don't you tell me he can't do it. Don't you tell me he can't do it. And I've seen families reunite. I've seen prodigals. Don't you tell me he can. Don't you tell me he can. Say, I've seen troubled souls. I've seen troubled souls delivered. And I've seen addicts finally free. Don't you tell me
he can't do it. Don't you tell me.
Say, I've seen cancer. I've seen cancer disappear. I've seen metal. But don't you tell me he can't do it. Don't you
tell me.
I've seen a real life resurrection. I've seen mental. I've seen mental health restored. But don't you tell me he can't do it. Don't you tell me. And I've seen families reunited. And I've seen prodigals return. Don't you tell me he can't do it. Don't you
tell me.
Say, I've seen troubled souls. And I've seen troubled souls delivered. And I've seen addicts finally free. Don't you tell me. We'll see cities. We'll see cities in. And salvation flood the streets. Don't you tell me he can't do it. Don't you
tell me.
say we'll see glory fill the nation like the world has never seen. But don't you tell me he can't do it, 'cause I know that he can. Oh, I believe you're the wonder-working God. You're the wonder-working God. All the miracles you're too good to not. You're the wonder-working, and you heal because you love. Yeah. After everything I've seen, you're too good. You're the wonder-working God. You're the wonder. All the miracles you're too good to not believe. You're the wonder-working. You kill because you love. After everything, too good to not, too good to not believe, too good to not believe. After everything, too good to not, too good to not believe, too good to not believe. You're too good to not believe. You're too good to not believe. You're too good to not believe. Oh, oh. You're too good to not believe. You're too good to not believe. After everything I've seen, too good to not believe. Too good to not believe. Too good. After everything I've seen, too good to not believe. Too good to not believe. Everywhere that I go, all I see is your goodness surrounding me. Everywhere that I go, all I feel is your love surrounding me. Everywhere that I go, all I feel is your peace surrounding me. After everything I've seen, too good to not believe. After everything I've seen, too good to not believe. Too good to not believe. You're so holy, Jesus. Everything you do is holy. Everything you do is holy. Everything you do is holy. Just for me. Everything you do is holy. Everything you do is holy. Everything you do is holy. Jesus. 'Cause everything you do is holy. Everything you do is holy. Everything you do is holy. Jesus, you alone deserve the glory. You alone deserve the glory. You alone deserve the glory. Jesus, you alone deserve the glory. You alone deserve the glory. You alone deserve the glory, Jesus. Yeah. Come on, don't wait for me. Don't wait for me. There's a song in your heart this morning. Don't wait for me. Don't wait on us to take you there. Lead yourself there this morning. The same spirit that lives in me lives in you. So what's your song this morning? What's your prayer this morning? Stir up your heart this morning. Oh, in my head, oh, we thank you for your presence, Jesus. We thank you for your presence. Just a little bit more, just a little bit more. Just push yourself a little bit more.
If you need increased finances, he is it. The Lord woke me up about 6:39 this morning. And he began to deal with me. I've talked about this before. You've heard this before by many of the leaders in this house. Joel 2:28. About he would pour out his spirit on all flesh. But he didn't let me go past that point into the your sons and daughters will prophesy. He had me stuck at I will pour. I will pour. And I said, oh my God, Lord, what do you want to pour today? And he reminded me of another passage of scripture. If you fast forward through the Old Testament and go to Malachi 3, that's another place he talked about pouring. He was talking about laying the foundation of if you do this, I will do that. And then if you try me now in this, and will I not open up the windows of heaven and pour? You are the blessing. And then he showed me a cup. And I thought about this cup. If you pour into a cup, there's only so much. So this cup is about 8 ounces. And that's as much as you can get. That's the capacity of the cup. And if you were to take this lid and to cover it, it's limited. It's limited. Well, if you think about Wednesday, this past Wednesday, the man of God, Pastor Gabriel, said, I am removing limitations. I'm removing limitations. Take the lid off. And not only that, the man of God said, I'm stretching. So I said, how does this work together? He said, not only am I removing limitations, taking the lid, the ceiling off of your life, but I'm stretching your cup. So not only am I pouring in to the point of overflow that you will have room not enough to receive, but I'm expanding your cup for more overflow. What do you need? The Spirit of God told me this morning to tell you, put what you need in the cup. What do you need? The Lord says, if you speak it, I'll pour. If you need increased finances, I will pour. If you need healing, I will pour. If you need deliverance, I will pour. Do you want more of my spirit? I will pour. So take the limitations off. Stretch yourself. I know we get real comfortable with the same thing every Sunday, but the Lord says, stretch yourself out in worship. Stretch in my presence. Worship me in a new way. He is doing a new thing. Your 2024, you ain't gotta wait for it. It's now. It's now. So God says, try me now in this. He said, try me. Most times people don't want you to try them because you don't want to see what it is. But what God's got for you, it is good. Good morning, Prince of Peace. If you would greet your neighbor, we're so glad you're with us. God bless you. God bless you. I recognize there are many ministries you could have come to visit, but you decided to worship with us. And what God is doing in this season. And you know, just to throw this caveat in there, I said he woke me up at 6:39. For all my visionaries and prophetic seers and dreamers, numbers in the Bible have meaning. 6 is the number of man. It represents our frailties, our weaknesses. 3 is the number of completion, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. And 9 is absolute completion. It's the number after 8, which is the new beginning. So God has confirmed his word in this house through the man of God that he is stretching us. He is taking off limitations and he's giving us capacity for more. I'm excited. I don't know about you, but I'm going to try him and I'm going to taste and see that the Lord is good. So on this morning, when you give your seed, I want you to sow in the word of God, the prophetic word that was released by Pastor Gabriel this past Wednesday for removing limitations and stretching our capacity. And it doesn't matter if it's $5, $50, $5,000, $50,000. It's about the posture of your heart when you give it. So give with expectation. When you come into the house, do you just come because it's something to do? Or do you come expecting for him to pour? You need him to pour. We cannot make it without his spirit. So as we all stand in this house, there are several ways to give. You can give in person right here. You can also give online through our website at princeofpeace.us. You can also sow through our Cash App. And when you're ready, you can stand. Glory to God. Glory to God. We thank you, Father God, for the stretching and for the removal of limitations. And we believe that you're going to bless us and increase us some 30, some 60, some even 100-fold. And not just financially, we're looking for increase in our spirit. We're looking for an outpouring of yourself into us. The giftings, release it. The release, prophetic words, release. Dreams and visions, release. And increase support and ministry and servanthood in this house. In Jesus' name, amen. Bring your offering.
Good morning, Prince of Peace. Come on, good morning. Turn to your neighbor. Let them know, hey, it's a new day. It's a new day. Maybe the next one, because maybe they didn't brush their teeth, or it seems like you're scratching the dust out of their eyes. It's a new day. What does a new day bring? Anybody? What's a new day bring? A fresh start. A fresh start. When we say a fresh start, we look at that. What? It's hope. We've been doing this series called Rooted, Having Stability in an Unstable World. And God is hope. You woke up today. It's a new day. You made it through yesterday. You made it through this week. You made it through the month. You made it through the quarter. You made it so far this year. There's hope. Because this world, we need hope. We need hope. It's a hurting world. It's a fallen world. There's a lot of things that try to bring us down. But we have hope. Could you stand with me for a minute? We want to read the word. And we're going to look at today Romans 15, 13. When you have it, just say amen. All right, we got two people that got it. It's on the screen anyway, so here we go. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace in believing, so that the power of the Holy Spirit you may abound. Say abound. You know, Bridget was just saying that your cup running over, it's filling it over, abounding. I mean, more than enough, more than I can have, more than my capacity, that I could share it with someone else. Abound in hope. Abounding in hope. Be seated. I want to recognize my mother-in-law, Mom. You know, the Bible says to honor your mother and father. So, you know, my father-in-law, he wanted to be here. He's a little sick. So my hope is that by his stripes that we are healed. So that's my hope. My hope. Hope. Man, when we look at hope, We look at what the world says about hope, and we look at a biblical hope. You know, and hope, what do we have if we don't have hope? You know, suicide, that generally happens is because they've run out of hope. That the circumstances, they've weighed them and just said, man, there's nothing more. I can't do this no more. I got no more hope. I can't live with what is bearing down on me. And they lose hope. They lose the zeal, the will to keep going on. So hope, I want to look at the definitions of hope here, of what, you know, Webster says and all those places, and what the Bible says about hope. So let's look at these definitions. The definitions of, the dictionaries is that the general consensus of all dictionary definitions is that hope is a feeling of expectation, a desire or a wish for a certain thing to happen. Right? Sometimes our hope isn't always a good hope. Like, man, I hope my boss breaks his leg so he don't come in. I mean, that guy's been riding my tail. Right? So sometimes our hope isn't always in the positive. We kind of get caught in this world thing. Right? But a lot of times, too, our hope is that the Buffalo Bills are going to make it to the Super Bowl. Hope. So we hope. It's a wish, right? It's not certain, but we have an expectation for an outcome desire, a desire that's beneficial to us, right? But let's look at the biblical definition of hope. A biblical definition of hope takes it one step further. Hope is an expectation with certainty. Say it with me again. Certainty. Certainty that God will do what he says that he will do. There's a certainty. I hope you caught that. There's wishing, and then the biblical hope is a certainty. We stand on a confidence. Not wishful thinking, but a confidence. So, hope is rooted in God's promise and his oath. Media, if you can go to Hebrews 6:18. That two immutable things in which it is impossible for God to lie, that we might have a strong, is it weak? It's strong consolation, who have fled for the refuge to lay hold of the hope set before us. So the thing is the reason for our hope, why it's certain, is because God says that he can't lie and I will never break my oath. God is the God of hope. He is the hope. What is that? So when he says that, when we look at, if you go back to my original verse here, which is Romans 13, please, if you can go back to that. It says the first part is may. May God of hope. And then if we look at it, that you may abound. May. When we look at may, does that sound confident? Like it's a certainty? Does it? Does may sound like it's a certainty? So wait a second. Why is this may? We're going to get back to it. I want to circle back to that, but keep that there in your head. So let's read it without the may, right? God of hope fill you with all joy. Not some, all. All joy and peace as you trust in him. Trust. There's a trust that we have in this hope. What? Hold on. So that you overflow with hope. How is it? How do we overflow? It's by the power of the Holy Spirit. By the power of the Holy Spirit. See, because if we look at the world, we wish. And a lot of times when we wish for things, there's a void, there's an emptiness. There's like what they call a when-then thinking. When I get the job, then I'll be successful. Then I'll have peace. When I find that special woman or that man, then I'll be happy. Hope. He is the God of hope. Because his word and his oath, he can't lie. But can I be honest with you? I've doubted hope. Some of you know my testimony. I have a sickness. I've hoped. I've prayed. Lord, take this cup from me. Take it. Take it. Take it. Take it. So can I say that I've always walked complete hope? For a moment there, I thought sickness was gone. I thought that everything was going to be all right. And then it came back. So for a moment there, my hope, things was good. Things were well. I was doing well. And then it came back. My hope was shaken. Has anyone had their hope shaken? So how? Oh. Thank you, Omar. When we haven't seen the promise, when we haven't seen the results, when we've prayed the prayer, and we believed with our whole hearts that his promises and his oath is going to come through, that he won't waver. But I began to wonder. I began to doubt. I began to question. Just like the father who had the demon-possessed son, he said, Lord, I believe. Just help. Help me with my unbelief. What is he saying? He's like, Lord, I have hope. My hope that my son is going to get better. I have hope. But my hope is in you, not in me, not in this world, not my wishful thinking. You see, a lot of times this world, what they want to tell you, you can go get it. Go and do things. Matter of fact, my wife, we were just looking at getting a new office for her. And actually, we started giving a little testimony to the guy about, you know, who I am. I'm like, all right, yeah, I'm a pastor. And he's like, you know, I said, but we're gonna pray on this, and we're going to see. He's like, man, you can't do that. You just got to go get it. You got to go get that. I'm like, dude, I'm also a salesman. I know how to get things, okay? All right? So, in the world, we can go after our wishful thinking, and quite frankly, there's a lot of things that we can obtain under our own strength and our own wisdom. But that when-then thinking, that go-get-it mentality, there's an emptiness even after we get it. There's a level of unsatisfaction because it becomes, well, what next? You see, but when we have hope in the Lord, we can do all things. Now, that doesn't mean if I run off here and I say that I'm going to levitate, I'm going to levitate. let's not twist some of the things what it says in the Bible, okay? So, but when he says that we can do all things, that means that I can go through any, I can endure, I can persevere through all the things. Thank you, two people. I can persevere through these things. That hope, the certainty that his promise will come. And that's the difficult thing in this world, because we're so used to getting everything that we want in a matter of seconds. It's at our fingertips, this little machine. We can look up just about anything. If I'm sad, I can play a funny video, you know? I can make me laugh. If I want to look up something, hey Siri, you know, boom. And it's going to look something up. So we put that hope in there, but you see, but when God, we put the hope in the good times, the hope that his word was fulfilled, that his promises, you're looking for a house, right? We have hope that we're going to find the house. We've been looking for months right now, right? But that house hasn't come up yet. Have you doubted? Have you said, Lord, where's that house? I don't know. I don't know if I can trust in you with that house. He's like, hey, wait. I know the desires of your heart. I know exactly what you want. Wait on me. Wait on me. Hope. Wait. Because see, hope. Can you go to Romans 5:5, please, media? And this hope will not lead to disappointment. It's not going to lead to disappointment. It's not. For we know that we have a God who dearly loves us. How do we know of his love? Because he has given us the Holy Spirit to fill our hearts with his love. See, our hope. Now, sorry. Can we go to Hebrews, back to Hebrews, Hebrews 11. We're going to go back and forth a little bit, but you're going to understand it here. Hebrews 11, it's pretty popular. It's about faith, right? What is faith? So let's look at this. Now, faith, say it with me, faith is confidence in what we hope for. It's confidence. Why is it confidence? Because it's a certainty. It's a biblical hope. A biblical hope. What is biblical hope again? Let's go back to looking at biblical hope. Biblical hope. Biblical hope. Biblical hope. I got my notes all over the place. God was working with me this morning. Biblical hope is an expectation with a certainty that God will do what he said that he will do. Said he will do. So let's look at faith. Faith, 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 faith. It's confidence in what we hope for. What is hope again? That is, like I said, certainty. Hope is an expectation with certainty that God will do what he said he will do. And it is the assurance. Say it with me, assurance. What is assurance? It means that you take it to the bank. This check ain't going to bounce. All right? Go ahead, cash it right now. It's not one of like, hey. The way my bank account works is that, you Kevin Hart fans out there, you know what I'm talking about. It's not like that type of assurance, okay? It is like, you can take it now, cash it, it's good. About what we do not see. Because if we see hope, it's not really hope because we already have it. We have it, it's obtained. So I'm not only hoping anymore, I got it. I deposited that check, it's in my bank. So hope is about future. That is the God of hope. Everything is based on the God of hope, that all his promises, all his word, everything he says is true. I can bank on it. I can take it to the account. I don't have to worry in the waiting. I don't have to worry in the circumstances that the wind and the waves that are coming against me. I know that it will come to pass. That is your hope. Oh, but let me tell you, it ain't easy. See, one thing I love when I'm reading and studying about God, God is simple, but yet it's complex. It's simple. Like I said, just hope. Just hope in the Lord. Wait on the Lord. Sweet Jesus, I'm waiting. I mean, you know, what Moses and those guys were walking around the desert for 40 years. Hope. Hope, 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 hope. It is future. The hope in glory. Hope. The hope that this is. That there's going to be an eternity. That the hurt, the fallenness of this world, the persecution, the challenges, the bitterness, the disappointments, all that. That I have a hope that one day he's going to come and that every knee will bow and every tongue will confess that he is Lord. That no more sorrow, no more crying. He's going to wipe every tear. That have you thought of this? Have you ever really sat there and thought about this? Like, what would it be like to not have any hate in this world? What would it be like to just love? Just, it's just all around. It just don't matter where you go, where you look at. I look at you, you smile. I look at you, look at baby, I smile. We love, man. There's no hate here. You know, I don't got to worry about what you take from me taking from you. It's there's so much and it abounds. It's endless. Hope is the center. It is what roots us. Because if God is not who he says he is, and his word isn't what he says it is, his oath to say, Kelvin, I'm going to do what I said I'm going to do. In spite of everything that you see right now. In spite. Doesn't matter. I'm going to do what I said I'm going to do. That is the hope that you have. That is the hope. The hope that we have is in his word. There are over 7,000, they say, promises if you look in the Bible. Whatever you're struggling with, there is a word in his word that you can call on. And it's not reminding him like he forgot that he said those things. Believe me, he didn't. He put them in there for a reason. And it's for you and him to have a connection. It's for you and him to have a relationship. It's for you to put your trust in him, your hope in him, not in this world, not in your own, but him. But there's a process, right? I love Sean McDermott, you know. Trust the process. Trust the process. You know, and if you've, anyone here sports fans? Well, there's a Dallas person, so that's not really a true Dallas. You know, that's not really a true fan. So, but his character has been attacked. His character was attacked by a story that was put out there, and you know, and I love it because he said, you know, if you know really who I am and my character, I'm a man of faith. I'm a man of faith. And how I was raised and what I believe in, you know, I'm going to do the right thing. But he, and this is just what I, he's like, I'm not a perfect man. I'm not a perfect man. I've said things, I've done things that aren't right. But my intentions and what I try to do and what I try to do with this team is are good. Maybe I didn't say it right. Maybe it didn't come out right, but they're good. And that takes a lot to admit, right? That I screwed up. To let everyone know, to have that vulnerability. Because a lot of us, that we don't want to put ourselves out there. We don't want to be vulnerable to have people see that maybe we didn't do things right. Maybe I didn't have my priorities right. Maybe I was in that when-then thinking. But when I'm vulnerable to God, and I say, you know what? My hope is in you. I've tried this thing. I've tried. But Lord, man, I couldn't get it right. But you know what? Even with all this mess that I created, if you remember Bridget's talk, right? Your mess could be your message. I know that you can work all things for my good. You can work all things for my good. Even when I screwed up, even when I wasn't faithful, even when I stepped off the path, you can take that and say, don't worry, son. Don't worry, son. I'm going to make it work for your good. Even when you doubted me. Just like Peter. Isn't that the disciple of Jesus? When the rooster crows 3 times, you'll deny me, Peter. No, not me. Yet on this rock, Peter, I'm going to build my church, because hope. Jesus saw the future with Peter, and he knew. Some of us, our hope it's been eroded. And we need him to come back and meet with us. We need him to give us a touch. Now faith. What is the faith in that? Is the trust. Because faith is the confidence in what we hope for. It's the action. You see, because there's another thing that sometimes what we do is that we say, well, all right, I'm going to hope and I'm going to wait. There's a skill in hope. There's a skill in a hope. Because hope isn't just waiting and no activity. Pastor talked about this, is that one of the things that we do is we got praise, right? So I'm going to praise him in the waiting. I'm going to praise him no matter what. No matter what has happened, Lord, I'm still going to praise you because I'm still here today. You've given me today. There's meditation. You know, I can tell you this. There's been a lot of times when I was kind of doubting or kind of low in my hope. And that's all was a word. And throughout the day, I just kept saying that word. Because in his word, Romans, is the renewing of our mind so that we have a Christ-like mind. And the way that we can renew that mind is on the constant, the meditation of the word. Because a lot of times people say, man, Jeff, it's hard. I mean, I wake up, I got the kids, and then I got work, and then I'm at work, and then all of a sudden then we're done with work, and then I got to go get the kids, and then it's just, bam, 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 bam. It's hard to really just always, be in prayer and reading, right? It's just, that's hard. But the things have, if you just took the minute before your feet hit the bed, or you hit the floor, before you get out of that bed, and you just, just read that one verse, that one word, and you just let that, you just keep bringing it back to your attention throughout the day. When your boss is like, hey, you got that report? Wait on the Lord. Wait on the Lord. He will renew your strength. So wait I'm meditating on that. That's what I'm saying to him in my mind. I really didn't say that. But that's what I'm meditating on, because I'm like, well, I would have the report, but you didn't give me the numbers. You didn't give me this or that. We can go down that, you know, this for that type of thing. But when we meditate, it is a skill. It's a skill. When we praise, it's a skill. It's a choice that we're saying, Lord, I'm here. Lord, I trust in you. Lord, I am making myself present to you now. It's a skill to praise. It's a skill. But it's... I do a lot of sports references, so I apologize. But so, Allen Iverson. I remember Allen Iverson? Yeah, beautiful point guard, Philadelphia 76ers. There's a pretty famous clip of him. We're talking about practice. We're talking about practice. Not a game, but practice. We're talking about practice. The thing that's different, though, for us is the game of life. The game of being a Christian is every moment, every day. So the skill, the discipline to be a disciple is an everyday thing. It's an every moment thing. It's a skill that we have to learn to do time and time again. We have to keep going to the well. We have to keep coming and practicing. That's why it says, I pray without ceasing. Because as we begin to just start making ourselves available and vulnerable to God and just say, Lord, here I am. Here I am. I showed up to work today. I showed up for you today. I thank you because you gave me the day today. So I trust in you that you're gonna guide my steps, that you are a lamp unto my feet. I just start meditating on the because it says also in the Bible, when I just get me to study the words and study the scripture, that it begins to be written on my heart. And where your treasure is, that's where your heart is, and that's where you'll find your treasure. So what are you treasuring? Where is your hope? Is your hope, is your treasure in the world, or is it in me? Where is the object and focus of your hope? So if I'm going to do this thing, Christianity, if I'm going to be a disciple, I need the discipline. I need to practice. I need to practice every day. I need to show up to the game each and every day. I need to meditate. I need to pray. I need to worship. I need you to fill me. I need hope. I need hope that you're there with me. Like your word says, that you're never going to leave me, that you're never going to forsake me. Because, man, there's days, right? Is there days that you just felt like, where are you, Lord? Where are you? Hope. Hope is the center. Hope is the center. That's why he says, I am the God of hope. The object of all this is that, where is our trust? Where is our source? It is God. He's the object of our hope. Psalm 27 says, some trust in chariots, some trust in horses, but we trust in the name of the Lord. If God is not the focal point of your hope, then the certainty is removed. The certainty is removed if God isn't the center. Hebrews 6, 9, so we just looked at, can you put it back up, Hebrews 6, 18? So those two immutable things, right, is that he doesn't lie and he will not break his oath. Hebrews 6, 19 says that is our anchor. So if we are going to be rooted, the anchor is that he doesn't lie, that everything that is in this word right here is true. Everything. Do you know that since the beginning of time with this has been trying to be challenged? People have been trying to poke holes in the validity of this. They've been trying to disprove this. when miracles happen, when we were just singing that they've seen steel plates dissolve. People can't come with an explanation. People have been nothing but trying to disprove this. But you can be certain. I don't have enough faith to not believe. I don't have enough faith to not hope that this is true. There's a speaker in he's fantastic. And his group is I don't have enough faith to be an atheist. And he goes around college campuses and that's what he does. He debates and he defends the word and he brings logic and he brings truth and he brings science and he brings everything back to the word. Everything's grounded back to the word. Hope is the anchor. Hope in his word that is true. Hope that he will not break his promises. In spite of what I see, in spite of what's going on, in spite, the conditions are circumstances, no matter what and how it comes, I have hope in God. I have hope in his promises. Hope has come and is through. So when Jesus died and he was resurrected, he said that I'm going to send help. I'm going to send the advocate. It's the Holy Spirit. And that, the Holy Spirit, you see, is what keeps hope alive inside of us. It's what gives us the discernment. It gives us, like you've heard, spirit knows spirit. Right? Have you heard that before? Spirit knows spirit. It's because the Holy Spirit gives us discernment. When we're doing the practice, when we're doing the praise, when we're reading, when we're praying, the Holy Spirit stirs up and brings the truth. That's why when we were looking at from the very beginning, when we talked, if you can bring back Romans 15:13, so that you overflow with hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. Jesus knew that he had to be with us at all times. When we are witnessing and there's people that don't believe, right? You can spit to the truth. You can talk about all the promises. You can bring in the history of the Bible. That no matter, like I said, the history of the Bible cannot be refuted. It is irrefutable. People have tried to say that the Bible is just made up stories, but when you look at history in the Bible, kings, places, they are constantly finding through archaeology and science that that place existed, that those it happened. And people will say, well, really, a sea? How can a sea just open up? They've done. There's been scientists, as I believe, who show somewhere in the Red Sea where the level of the sea is not so much, and if a certain wind came, that it could part. That is, there is that chance. When they talked about Sodom and Gomorrah and how it hailed, they're finding in an area that the purest of those stones is like it's there. It's there. The history, you can't deny it. That's why we have the hope. The hope is sure. So he knew that his spirit had to be with us, because when we begin to speak to people who have not, speaking to people who may have hope in themselves, but at some point that hope is going to be lost. Because we're in a hurting world. We're in a world that needs hope. And it's not by my might or my wisdom that will change them. But it's through the Holy Spirit that you'll worship in spirit and in truth. That is the hope. That is the hope that we have. As I close here, God doesn't want you to lose hope today. He doesn't want you to lose hope. I could share with you that I could be vulnerable with you. I've lost hope at times. A saint falls down, but he'll get back up again. And he keeps trusting. If you've lost hope, like I said, he doesn't want you to lose hope. He wants you to come back. If you struggle with hope, I can tell you it's okay to be vulnerable there. In the Word, there's people that are in the hall of fame of hope in Hebrews. Abraham struggled with hope. How's that? Isaac. He was promised Isaac, but Sarah and him kept trying and no child. They tried on their own to make the promise come forth, and they had Ishmael. So yeah, he struggled with hope. Joseph, he struggled with hope. He was given a vision, and then he was thrown into a pit, deceived by his brothers, and then from the pit he was sold into slavery. And then some woman wanted to get with him, made lies. And then he was thrown into a prison. And he's stuck in a prison. He lost hope. David was anointed by Samuel to replace Saul as king. But years before he became king. Matter of fact, he started losing his mind to it. He went to a cave. He lost hope. And as I mentioned earlier, there was the man with the demon-possessed son. He wanted to believe. He wanted to have hope that the healing would happen, but help me with my unbelief. God is the God of hope. He's here for you now. If anyone here doesn't know Jesus as their Lord and Savior, if you don't know God as the God of hope, just raise your hand so we can pray with you right now. Amen. If you feel that your hope needs to be restored, and you believe, but you need help in bringing that back, whatever the circumstances may be. Maybe you lost a loved one. Maybe you're struggling with something that you feel that you can't overcome. That the situation has been, it's been that way for a long, long time, and you just don't know if it's ever going to change. You don't know if you have the strength to keep persevering. We want to pray with you. So if you could stand with me and repeat with me. Lord, help me today. Put my complete hope and trust in you. Come on, no.
You're my hope.
Come on. Say with conviction. Lord, help me today to put my complete hope and trust in you. You are God and cannot lie. So if you said it, you will do it. It is your word. It's your oath. It is your promise that you will not lie. hope in you like Job did. Knowing that you will come through like you did for Abraham and Isaac. Fulfill what you have promised me on my behalf. In the powerful and almighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen and amen. So I just want to say we have intercessors here. And Pastor and I, we talk about this, and it's like, now's the time. You don't want to miss the moment and then like afterwards and say, hey, you know what, can you pray for me? No, now is the time. Now is the moment. If you've struggled with something, if you need hope to arise again, if you need to know that hope has come, that hope is in the room, I ask you to come forward. We have intercessors here that will pray for you. So I thank you. And then we're going to end here with just praising him that hope is here.
Hope in Jesus.
One more time.
said there is hope. There is hope in Jesus.
In Jesus.
Present help.
Present help.
Redeemer.
Redeemer.
As long as I am.
As long as I am.
Still breathing.
Still breathing.
As long as I am.
As long as I am.
Still breathing.
Every hand lifted. Father, we thank you. Thank you, thank you. Thank you for a hope that we can put in you. It is a hope that does not disappoint. Speak to every heart. You've spoken to every heart here in the room. You've spoken to every heart in the room. Because Jesus has come, hope has come. Hope has come. We thank you for the power of your word. Thank you. Thank you for the power of your word. Were you blessed by that word today? So were you blessed by that word today? Amen. For those that probably heard Pastor Jeff today, maybe for the first time or maybe your second time, he helps my wife and I, him and Millie, help us pastor this church, specifically this service. And for, I would say, what has it been now since you found out about Castleman's? How long has it been now? 2016. So right around, almost now going into 8 years. 8 years. He's been going through pretty much what would be considered an incurable disease, right? They're still finding out about new discoveries, new treatments for it. During this time, and as you hear him today, he's still receiving treatment to date. You never know the story of the person that's standing up here. And if you only associate God speaking in this house to whenever I speak, you can miss God. Today, I know God spoke to somebody, because I could hear it in the room, and I could hear I could hear hearts beating again with hope. That's why in the next several weeks we're going to be, next week I'm going into a 2-week sort of series about hope has come, and just preparation into Christmas. Today I preach second in Niagara Falls, but I thank God. How many thank God for Pastor Jeff? Come on, how many can thank God for his life, his family? His kids are here. Deborah's probably watching online. Amen. Would you guys come? I want to pray for you all. Just come forward. Yeah, right there. Hallelujah. Come on, family. Yeah. Come on, come on. Come on, man. I want you to stretch your hands to this man of God and pray for him like you're praying for your own family. What is incurable for man is more than possible for God. What man sees no cure for, we believe that God is still a healer. And so, Father, right now in the name of Jesus, we thank you for the healing that's taking place in this body. You use modern science to bring healing. We don't curse doctors. We bless them. And we thank God. One of your disciples was a doctor. And we thank you, Lord, that you're using modern medicine to heal this man's body. We thank you, God, that it's so appropriate to even where you have Millie right now to heal. The healing grace that is upon their lives. Not just the healing that you're using them to heal others, but even the process of healing within themselves. I pray blessing upon this family, Lord, that the best years of their marriage is ahead of them. The best years for their family is ahead of them. These will be years of great blessing, says the Lord to you. This is going to be years of great peace, says the Lord, towards you. People are going to come to you for peace. I need peace. Peace of mind. Yep. Father, I thank you for the overwhelming blessing that is upon their lives. I declare the blessing of the Lord upon your business, Millie. The blessing of the Lord upon it. Thank you, Lord, because of the grace that is upon their lives and the assignment that they have come to this house with. Thank you for this family, Austin. Thank you for Brianna. Thank you even for Deborah, who's not here, and Cammy. Thank you, Lord God, for their children. And I thank you for this house, because they have been planted in this house and serves as such a blessing. Now bless them in return. We declare that there would be an overflow of joy, an overflow of peace, an overflow of rest in this season for them. In the mighty, magnificent, miracle-working name of Jesus Christ, amen and amen. Come on, can you believe it today for them? We believe it's done, sealed, signed, delivered. How many believe it? Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Tell your neighbor, God spoke to you today. Come on, come on. Tell the other neighbor, there's hope, there's hope, there's hope. There's hope, there's hope, there's hope. A hope that does not disappoint. Were you blessed today? Were you blessed today? Amen. Tribal is going to be having a Christmas bowling party this Saturday at 2 p.m. If you'd like to be a part of it. Where are the young people at in the room? Amen. You should have said something there. You should have said, How many young people do I have in the room? Amen. If you wish and desire to be a part of that, you can see Victoria, Omar, right in the back of as you exit today, as you leave, you can see them and let them know that you'd love to be a part of that. As I mentioned before, these next 2 weeks, we're going to be just coming into introduction with Christmas and speaking about hope has come. I want you to take this opportunity. I want to ask you, invite your family to church on Christmas Eve. We will have an all campus, all locations will be in one place. We will figure that out. We'll have overflow downstairs. We'll put additional chairs in here. But this is a great opportunity. We have some families already that have joined us in Niagara Falls. How many can thank God for that? Amen. We've had some families join us in Niagara Falls. We have some people here for second service. I know we typically meet each other in passing. And so this is a perfect opportunity for you to meet somebody that's in a different service. You typically find that person that you always see at work or at the grocery store actually goes to the same church you do. And this is a perfect time to connect with them. December the 24th at 10 a.m. Amen. And then New Year's. God was already talking to me about New Year's Eve. New Year's is not a word, so God's already talking to me about the new year. Amen. For all those people that kids saying Happy New Year's with a nest, that's not a word. Amen. Amen. That is so annoying. Lord, help us. Amen. New Year's Eve, you're referring to something. Amen. New Year's Eve, Sunday, that 31st, we will be here. And we're going then back to our regularly scheduled program with an interruption. And then, can I give you a preview to January? The Holy Spirit's already, no coincidence there, but God has really been impressing on me about January. And so the entire month of January, I'm going to speak specifically about the Holy Spirit. About the Holy Spirit, the power that you have by the Holy Spirit. And so we hear this word, Holy Spirit, you know, the Spirit of God. What does that mean and how you can overcome because God's Spirit lives inside of you? But New Year's Eve Sunday is going to be bananas. Last year, or this year, God moved in such a special way, and we're thankful for that. Let's stand on our feet. If you still desire to be a part of our serve team, serve in any way, capacity, shape, form, you can fill out that QR code or scan the QR code. There's different ministries that you can serve a part in the month of February is when we're looking to do our leadership gathering, where we're going to be, this is a time where you hear from my wife and I, our vision, what the Lord has for Prince of Peace, and not even just Prince of Peace Buffalo, but Prince of Peace Niagara Falls. We've also had some people reach out to us, Pastor, can I help provide lunch for the worship team on Sunday? Something light, a light lunch, a salad or a soup or something like that. There's, you know, you can do that once every 2 months. I think we have almost all the weeks committed. But that way you can be a part of that as well. If you love to give into the children's ministry, we feed the children every Sunday. They get a full meal, y'all. My kids, by the time we go to eat lunch, they don't want to eat because they've ate three lunches. Amen. And their food and their clothes is full of syrup. And so we there's so many things for you to be a part of. And then also, if you have family members, friends that live in the northern part of the city, let's say Tonawanda, thank you, Niagara Falls, Lewiston, Clarence, Lockport, anybody within the north towns, send them our way in Niagara Falls at 1:30. The word I preach next service and this next service at 11:30 is not the same word I preach in Niagara Falls. I preach a different word at 1:30. And so you can send them our way. We want to serve. We want to be a blessing to them. Amen? And don't stop giving. Don't stop giving into what God is doing here locally at Prince of Peace. How many were blessed today? Every hand lifted. Let me bless you. Father, I bless your people. I declare that this is going to be the best week of our lives. Oh, no, nobody got that. I said, this is going to be the best week of our lives. I declare that the blessing, the favor of the Lord, glory to God. Man, woo, yes, Lord. Somebody receive that. The favor of the Lord is following you this week. I just prophesied. I hope somebody grabbed that in the air. I said that the favor of the Lord is going to follow you. Get ready to see the unmerited, unexpected favor of the Lord hit you over the head. It's going to hit your family. It's going to hit your friends, your loved ones in the mighty name of Jesus. Can somebody say amen? Amen. Amen. Greet two or three people on your way out. So good to see you, Prince of Peace. God bless you. We'll see you soon.
Thank you.